In this question on moment of forces, we are told that a uniform beam WX of length 90 cm and weight 50 newtons is suspended on a pivot, which is 35 cm from W. Now, the beam is kept in equilibrium by means of forces T and 20 newtons applied at Y and Z respectively. WY is 10 cm and SZ is 10 cm and we are asked to find the value of T. So, to go ahead trying to solve this question, we can as well just try and draw the particular beam that we are being told here. The fact that it is uniform means that it's going to be evenly distributed, okay? So if you have something like this, we can say the weight, which is the 50 newtons, will be acting at the middle of the beam. So we are told it is 90 centimeters, and the weight we just need to act down here. So this is 50 newtons. And that 50 newtons is going to be acting at the midpoint of the uniform beam, okay? Because it's uniform, this will act at the midpoint. And now, we're told that the length is 90 centimeters, so the midpoint will be 45 centimeters. Let's just note that. So we're not told that it is being suspended on a pivot, which is 35 centimeters from W. So if we take this as the point W, and we'll take this as the point X, now, 35 centimeters from W, since the weight is at the middle from here to here, that will be half of 90 centimeters. So, it will be 45 centimeters, which is half of the length of the beam. Okay. Then we are told that from 35 centimeters from W, so maybe somewhere like here, we have the support on a pivot. Can have a pivot here. Okay, so that pivot is 35 centimeters from W. So the distance from here to here, that will be 35 centimeters. Okay, so it is kept in equilibrium by means of forces T and 20 newtons applied at Y and Z respectively. Okay, so what is the position for Y? We are told that WY is 10 centimeters. So W to Y will be 10 centimeters, and at that point we have a force, which is, so down here we have a force T that is 10 centimeters from W. So this point is point Y, and it is 10 centimeters from W. Between W and Y is 10 centimeters, and then XZ from the other end, X to another point here, we have another force which was giving us 20 newtons, and this is also 10 centimeters. Okay, from the 20 newton force to X, so this is point Z. Okay, and we are now being asked to find the value of T. T is what we are looking for, so we can do well to finish up our diagram, because if you look at this, to find T, we can just take moment about one of the pivots, okay? So take a moment, we take the moment about the pivot, shade that in blue, okay? So we will try and evaluate the distance of each of the forces to this particular pivot. Now, look at this. We have seen that from W to the pivot is 35 centimeters. From W to T is 10 centimeters. So the remaining here will be 35 minus 10. So this place here is going to be 25 centimeters, so I can just append that this is 25 centimeters from this force to the pivot, okay? Then from the center of the uniform beam to this pivot, already from W to the center is 45 centimeters. Now we have taken 10 and 25, which is 35 centimeters out, so the remaining here is also 10 centimeters, okay? All right, good. So now we also have this force, the 20 newton force here, and we are told that it is 10 centimeters from X. The whole of the length is actually 90 centimeters as given in the question. If we take 10 centimeters out, then this remainder from W down to here should be 80, or better still, we can say since half of that length is 45 centimeters, you're taking 10 centimeters or so from here to Z, from the midpoint to Z will be 35 centimeters. Okay, so 35 plus 10, that is 45 on this right hand side. But we are looking at the distance from this 20 Newton force to the pivot, and that will be 35 plus this particular 10 that we have. So from here, this will be 45 centimeters. So those are the parameters that we'll be needing to actually evaluate this particular question here. And if we take a moment about the pivot, this is our point of interest now. I want to take the moment about the sum of the clockwise moments is equal to the sum of the counterclockwise moments. So that's what we are going to be using here. And if we look at that, taking this pivot, this particular force T will have a moment that is tending towards this side, okay? But for the 50 Newton, which is the weight of the uniform beam, it will be going like this, which is clockwise, okay? T will be counterclockwise, but the weight of the uniform beam will be clockwise. So we have this here to be clockwise. We have this to be counterclockwise. And for the 50 Newton, we also have this to be clockwise. So the sum of the moment in the clockwise direction is equal to the sum of the moment in the counterclockwise direction. So in the clockwise direction, we have 50 newtons multiplied by the distance, okay, because it is the product of the force and the perpendicular distance. And you can see the force is acting downwards, the distance is acting horizontally, the force is acting vertically, so that is perpendicular to one another. So 50 multiplied by the distance from the midpoint of the uniform beam to the pivot, that will be 50 multiplied by 10 centimeters, okay? This is the first clockwise, plus the second clockwise, that will be 20 multiplied by the distance from this 20 Newton force to the pivot, which we have gotten to be 45 centimeters, okay? Is equal to, now this is the clockwise. The counterclockwise will now be the product of the force T and its distance to the pivot, which is 25 centimeters, is equal to T multiplied by 25, all right? So we can just say from here, 25T is equal to 50 times 10 is 500 plus 20 times 45, that will be 2025 is 90, then with that 0, 100. So 25T is equal to 500 plus 900, that is 1400, such that the force T will be 1400 divided by 25, okay? So 1400 divided by 25 is going to give 56 newtons. So T is nothing but 56 newtons. And we have been able to get that because we are able to interpret our question appropriately and find the distance from each of the active points to the pivot. And then we take a moment about the pivot and we're able to get the value of force T to be 56 newtons. So these are the kind of videos that we constantly upload on DevTutor Academy so that they can help you to build your proficiency in your STEM subject and be the best that God had created it to be. If you are yet to subscribe to the channel, it is free of charge and it's not going to cost you anything, but you will have information and access to all of our videos once we upload them. So go ahead and subscribe to the channel, click on the like button, click on the notification bell so that you have notifications of our videos once we upload them. And until next time, God bless you.